Let's do one more set here. Good, take your feet wide. Lunge and reach, lunge and reach. Let's do four more here. Three, two, one. Perfect. Stand tall, bring those feet hip width apart. Squat, twist and reach. Squat, twist and reach.
Bring the action.
Let's take three more sets. Two more sets. One more set. Okay, all right. Toe touch, step, step. Toe touch, step, step. With the one, two, three in between. Keep it going. All right, give me one more. Good. Give me a little jogger march. Arms out and across. Bring those arms out to the side. Give me some circles. Circle the other direction. All right, and then a couple jumping jacks. Okay, from here, you can also do split jacks. Whatever works. Five, four, three, two, one. Good. March, jog it out. Okay. So, our first exercise today, we're going to be starting with a lunge that's all the way to the floor. So I'm going to grab my mat just to give a little extra padding to my knee. You're welcome to do whatever you'd like. We're going to be grabbing one dumbbell for a clean. So clean. Just kind of a pull up to the shoulder. So, this is what it looks like. I'll be in this tall kneel. And I'm gonna be tucking that back toe under because we're gonna be standing up into a lunge after the clean. So core is nice and tight. Pull up to shoulder, all the way to the top in that lunge, lower, and bring it down, okay? So we'll do 10 this side, 10 the other. Core tight. Pull up to shoulder, stand all the way, and down. Try and avoid rocking forward and back. Good. I'm halfway through the side. I've got one more. Good. When you're done, you'll switch to the other side. High kneel, right? You want knee over ankle, right? Stand tall. Weight comes to shoulder. You press with the foot to the top and back down. Good. I've got three more. I got a new tattoo, don't know what to tell you. Gotta look at you. Get all 10 in. And then stand up. All right. We're gonna be doing a supported row next, okay? So, here where we've got our benches, we're gonna be making a tripod. At home, you can use coffee table, sofa, whatever you've got. I'm gonna grab a heavier dumbbell. I come to a knee, a hand, and this foot sticks out to the side. The weight drops down in between core tight, I pull elbow towards ceiling, and back down for 10. Nice job, everybody. Two more. One more. Perfect. We'll do that other side. So you'll set it up the same way. Knee, anchor with the hand. Okay. Once you've got it, pull up and down. Elbow coming towards sky. Get all 10 of yours in. We'll start talking about our next one. So this next one, we're gonna be doing a squat with a halo. We're gonna bring our dumbbell in between our hands like this. It kind of sits at our collarbone. Feet are hip width apart, we sit back in that squat. At the top, I circle around my head. I try and alternate sides, so the next time I would circle that direction, okay? So, count the squats, 10 of them. We squat. Circle the head. We squat. Try and circle the head the other direction. Good. Judgment. Now, as far as the bird dog position, we come to all fours, wrists under shoulders, knees under hips, and you could just stay here and do the tricep kickback. If you want, you can take this foot back, and if you're on the floor, you can actually kickstand it, but otherwise, it's lifted up, okay? Elbow comes high, we straighten behind and bend. Straight behind and bend. Breathe. I've got my 10, and then I'll go to the other side. I'll set this, it up the same way. Anchor through that knee, that palm. Straighten and bend. Get all 10 in, and then stand up. This next one is multi-part, okay? I'm gonna break it down for you, give you some options. So, I'm gonna stand, weight in one hand, feet together. I'm gonna step out, push my hips back into a side lunge. The weight comes towards that foot, towards that ankle. I'm gonna come back in, balance on one foot. I've got a secret little curl there. gonna work for you. I'm gonna see if I can do this one. We'll see if it works. All right, here we go. And sometimes even for me, I'll have to tap in between. My balance starts to get a little shaky. So we're gonna slow it down. Good. Finding your body in the correct form. I've got two more. Get all 10 of yours in, and then you're ready for side two. It's the same thing, lunge. Tap it in, or go straight to that knee. Strong back to the whole thing. Okay, two more. Finish all of yours and then get a quick sip of water. Good. using a little bit of power. Just get that weight up to your shoulder. I've got one more this side. All right. Get all 10 of yours done. And then switch sides. Ankle under knee, right? Knee under hip. Up to shoulder, breast through, and down. Halfway through. I've got one more. Get ears all in. We set up for supported rows. So we're bracing with a knee and a hand. Other foot out to the side. Strong back. Elbow pulls high and down. Looks good. I've got three more here. One more. Get all 10 of yours in. And then set up for the other side. I've got two more. Get all 10 of yours in. Then we're gonna set up for squats and payloads. So one weight, holding it at collarbone. You decide how low you're taking that squat. We squat. We circle. We circle the other way. Either on the floor or on your bench. You're gonna take that opposite foot back or lift it, elbow comes high, straighten and bend. Get all 10 in, and then you can set up for that other side. Check the form before you get going. Side two. And we've got that multi-part one. side lunge, unspoken curl to overhead press, balancing on one foot if you can. Stand tall, lunge and reach, curl, press. Slow it down as much as you need to make it good. Two more. I'm definitely slowing down as I focus on four. Get all of side one in, and then get ready for side two. Here we go. All right, get all of those in. Then we're going to do reverse lunge, not reverse lunge. Forget both of those words. We're going to do a leg lower to reverse curl. No lunges, either on your bench or on the floor. Lower as slow as you can, nice and controlled. I'm going to take the ceiling, pulling the hips off the bench. The core is driving it. Get them all in and then grab some water. So next Monday will be my last Monday class that I will teach, okay? We're gonna do a circuit in the gym. Okay. So, online friends, if you wanna join, you'll have to come in person. Is anybody going to be here the Friday after Thanksgiving? That's supposed to be my last class, but I'm like, is anybody even going to come? It is the day after Thanksgiving. I will wear.
Don't take it personally.
I won't.
No, that's coming on the grand finale.
I know.
Is Friday
the grand finale? I mean, it might end up being the one for that class. All right.
Maybe the circuit class.
Yeah. I don't know why I put that away. We're doing our starting at the bottom lunge, clean to stand. Split those feet. Kneel tall, back toe curled under. Pull up the shoulder.
Stand.
Remember, core is tight. We're using a little bit of power to get that weight up, but we're not rocking forward and back. I've got one more, if I can count correctly. That's always the question. Get your 10 in, and then set up for side two. Kneel nice and tall, pull up the shoulder, and stand. I've got three more. Supported row is up next. One more this side. Get your 10 in and then move to side two. Looking strong, guys. Squat with payload. We are next one. Choose your weight appropriately. Hold it at collarbone. You got your foot apart. You sit back in that squat. We circle the head. We squat. We circle the other direction. Two more. All 10 in. Get ready for the tricep kickback. Okay? Lighter weight. You set that up either on top of your bench or on the floor. Whatever feels safest to you. Come to that all fours position. Optionally lift that opposite back leg. Elbow comes high. Straighten and bend. Side two. The upper arm stays nice movement comes from the elbow. It's to remind ourselves of good form when we're tired. It's when our body least wants to do it. Alright, we're gonna stand up. We've got side lunge. Roll across the body to a curl and a press. It's a good one. Slow it down as needed. Remember, form is important. Strength and balance in the room. Once you're done, weights can go to the side. We've got a final set of the leg lower reverse crunch. Remember, slow it down. Two more. You may have more or less. On my last one, I'm going to go super, super duper slow. Nice job, everybody. Did it all done? Grab some water. Manageable for that. We're coming at it from a high heel. One foot in front, one knee down. The weight comes above that front knee, drops here. So, pro tip, don't follow the weight with your eyes. Look straight ahead, find someone to look at, okay? If you follow the weight with your eyes, you're more likely to go down with your weight, okay? All right, so here we go. We lift, we drop, bring it back up. It comes towards that back hip, yeah. I was doing this with a client the other day, and I was standing in front of them, and they kept saying, look at me. They kept trying to, like, look away. I've got two more. One more. Once you're done with side one, set up for side two. Ankle under front knee. Bring that weight above that front knee. Drop to the back hip. Remember, keep the eyes looking forward. Stand nice and tall. Side. We're going to come to our bench and do what are called crossovers, okay? So, I'm going to stand on top and I'm going to center one of my feet. The other foot is going to tap side one, tap side two. Back and forth until I've tapped each side 10 times. So cross behind, tap to the side. Cross behind, tap to the side. Burning out that standing leg. I've got two more, I believe. Get all 10 in. Then come back to the top, recenter leg two. Cross behind, tap to the side. I've got two more, one more. Woo! What do you guys think? Can we do one more round of each of those?
Yeah.
All right, kneeling wood chops one final time. Split knee at the bottom. Grab that weight end to end. Lift above the front knee. Drop to the back hip. Look forward. I've got two more. Get all 10 of yours in. Put your own pace. And set up for side two. Two more. Side. Here we go. Three more. Get all 10 in. Then you can do side two. All 10 in. When you're done, you can grab some water and put away your dumbbells.
Thank you.
Come back to center. We're going to do a little cat camel, okay? So we round up and round down. Round one direction and the other. Loosening up the back. Give me one more. All right, come to a neutral spine here. We're going to thread the needle. We take one arm. We reach it through. We lean as much or as little into it as feels good. Back to center. Take this leg to the floor. We'll do that other side. Grab that knee, pull up towards your armpit. Hold here for a few breaths. And take that opposite hand, grab that knee, and gently pull across the body. Bring this knee back to center. Grab both those knees. Have them nice and wide and add a little rocking motion side to side if it feels good. All right, come to center. We're going to do figure four. Release the knee. Cross this ankle over the opposite thigh. Grab that bottom leg and gently pull. And think about trying to press this other knee away from you. Let's release to the other side. Cross the ankle over the opposite thigh. Grab that bottom leg and gently pull. And remember, that knee is not coming in towards your chest. It's pushing away. All right, release. Let's sit up. I like to grab the backs of my legs, gently pull. Have a seat. All right. We're going to interlace those fingers, push them away, and we're going to take them all the way up to the ceiling. Sitting nice and tall, lengthening through spine, wrists, and fingers. Release, roll the wrists as they come down. Roll them the other way. Take it out. We'll do two deep breaths, okay? Inhale, arms up. Exhale, arms down. One more inhale. Exhale. All right, thanks for being here. Friday, regular HIIT class. Monday, circuit in the gym. Friday, me nostalgically saying goodbye. I know, I'll be like.
No. We'll have a pageant for you with the.